Hello and welcome to BNC Sports. I'm James Hill. HBCU Athletics, Lynn Thompson is one of the best athletic directors in America, the vice president of intercollegiate athletics for the Bethune-Cookman University Wildcats. His contract actually expires at the end of June, a role he's held since 1991. He's stepping down. Lynn Thompson joins us live. I hope you and your family are well, sir. First and foremost, talk about the Wildcats and your experience with Bethune-Cookman and what it's been like for you personally.
It has been, James, nothing but a great story. And as I look at on the screen there, 1991 to 2021, wow, that's 30 years, man. And 30 years of nothing but great memories. Touching the lives of tremendous student athletes through a great team of professionals, coaches, athletic support professionals, and so many people who have made this great ride a successful one. And I'm blessed. I'm the blessed man on earth right now. And I'm so humbled about the outpouring of support from those who understand that my season is over now, and I made the decision a couple of days ago and notified the university that it was time for me to call it a day in terms of my role at Bethune-Cookman University. And I'll tell you what, James, and you've been there for many of those milestone moments where we celebrated the good, the bad, the wins, the losses, but through it all, we've graduated young people and put them into great places in the global economy and into the society of the world.
Lynn, take us back through some of those experiences and then take us to this week, why you've decided to go in a new direction and move forward.
Well, you know, those experiences made me the man that I am. It allowed me, working at Bethune-Cookman University was not a job. It became a ministry where we were able to touch, teach, and transform the lives of young men and women from around the world. We brought them together and they bought into a mission, and that mission of the university, it became heirs to the legacy of the great Dr. Mary McLeod Bethune. And we were able to do some phenomenal things for so many years, for three decades, can you believe it? And we've won a ton of championships. We've graduated thousands of student athletes who've now gone on to do tremendous things. But this week, I made good on a promise to my family. And my kids told me that, Dad, you've had some great teams, but the greatest team ever is your family. And this year, throughout the pandemic, it hit our community, our university, and it hit my family extremely hard. I lost my best friend. I lost my brother-in-law. COVID invaded my close circle in my family. My sister had it, and several other members of my family. We lost one of my mentors, not to COVID, but we lost him in late January, Jack Cy McLaren, and it caused me to take a look at, what's really important now, and it was most important that I take the time out to really refocus my energies on the most important things to me, and that was my family. And I think that there'll be new opportunities, and I've had an opportunity now to really take a chance on exploring some of those new opportunities. And I'm so blessed and so grateful.
Mr. Thompson, take us through some of those experiences. In particular, when we look at HBCU athletics, we see the Florida Classic. There's many classics around the country. Your Wildcats have competed in the Circle City Classic up in Indianapolis. There's several classics around the country, but take us into the Florida Classic, if you will.
Well, you're absolutely right. There are so many classics, but there's none like the Florida Classic. And let's start from a relationship standpoint. The Florida Classic happens to be that weekend of athletic competition between Florida A&M and Bethune-Cookman University. But it's much bigger than that. When you look at all the other classics around America and in the HBCU world, Bethune-Cookman and Florida A&M actually are the owners of the Florida Classic. We own it lock, stock, and barrel. And many of those classics are owned and operated by third-party entities. But we are the beneficiaries of some innovative thinking where the Florida Classic Consortium, which is an organization that is owned by both universities, we take care of all of the details. We split all the revenue, and both universities are in partnership. Can you believe that? While we might be in partnership on research projects and other things, athletically, the Florida Classic is a baby that's been created and owned and operated by both FAMU and BCU. And that's the beauty of it, because it generates over $30 million a weekend in Orlando and Orange County. And those dollars are much needed pieces of revenue that operate our programs and our institutions. And as you know, on that weekend, we've got revenue streams that support our band program, our alumni affairs office, our research entities, and our offices of institutional advancement. So the entire university spectrum and all of its stakeholders are involved in generating revenue, momentum, school spirit, and putting forth and furthering the brands of both of these two great institutions. That's what this is all about. And I'm so proud to have been a great part of this and a partner in this for so many years.
Lynn, when you meet a young lady or a young man and they walk across that stage and they get a degree and they come back to you and they say, hey, I'm a doctor, or I'm a lawyer, or a journalist, or a school teacher, or I'm a winner in life. When you have episodes like that, how special is that?
Oh, man. James, I made it a point that not only would I do it, but our senior staff, on every official visit to Bethune-Cookman University from a student athlete, it was mandatory that they meet me and the senior staff. Why? Because the buck stopped in my office. And I would guarantee the family and that student athlete that I would be there on graduation day. And as a part of the institution's cabinet, when those student athletes come across that stage, I would be at the end of the stage, shaking their hands and hugging them after they had shaken the hand of the president, because it was that important for me to seal the deal. And I tell student athletes, and I don't care what sport there is, you must have a finishing move. It could be in basketball, when you can double clutch and get to the rack and get to the rim, but you've got to finish. It can be in football, where you square up to make a tackle, but you've got to wrap up to finish. It can be in baseball, where you follow through with the pitch or the swing, or in golf with a great follow through. Whatever the sport it is, there's got to be a tremendous finishing move. And I tell student athletes that the ultimate finishing move is walking across the stage with your degree in hand, because our school motto is enter to learn and to part to serve. And athletically, we've added another piece, and that is return to invest. And by returning back to the program to invest, that ensures that the cycle will be continued.
Thank you, sir, Mr. Lynn Thompson from the Bethune-Cookman University. All right, NBA playoffs, game one, Miami Heat at the Milwaukee Bucks. Let me take you out to cold Milwaukee for the action. NBA playoffs, Bucks hosting the Miami Heat. Heat in their gold uniforms, overtime. Watch Goran Dragic can the three-pointer on the play. Yes, the game is tied at 107, closing seconds. Meet Chris Middleton. He takes the ball, shoots, and scores. Milwaukee Bucks having a good time, folks. Middleton with 27 points in the victory. Milwaukee Bucks 109, Miami Heat 107. And the fans, they celebrate. All right, finally, it's time for our BNC King of the Hill. His baseball journey started in Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic, through the STL, St. Louis, and now he's in Hollywood, California. Albert Pujols is our King of the Hill. Jose Alberto Pujols Alcatrana was born January 16th, 1980, in Santo Domingo, Dominican Republic. You're looking at video of Albert Pujols. He slapped his first home run with the L.A. Dodgers. He just came over from the Angels. He's a 10-time Major League Baseball All-Star, a 6-time Silver Slugger, and a 3-time National League MVP. Albert Pujols is a 2-time Major League Baseball World Series champion with the St. Louis Cardinals. He currently has 668 home runs. AP, Albert Pujols is our BNC King of the Hill. We will be right back.